The other thing, I need to say about cancer before I finish, I've nearly finished, is that I'm sick of this poor old Jim. He's fighting cancer, you know. I'm here to tell you tonight, I'm fighting fuck all. You know, I'm fighting. You know, this, you see on Facebook, Jim is so courageous, you know, he's waging a battle against cancer, you know, he's so brave. You know, he's waging this battle against cancer. No, I'm not. Most of the time, I spend lying in bed listening to Tina Turner, or I'm on my luxuriously cushioned couch, catching up with, you know, episodes of CSI and Nurse Jackie, you know. That's hardly a battle, is it? Know what I'm saying? So, anyway, to finish off, drummers annoying people, you know. This would be about the only joke in my stand-up routine, you know. What's the difference between a drummer and a drum machine? This is for the one guy who's playing the cajon in the audience. The difference between a drummer and a drum machine is you only have to punch information into a drum machine once. Okay? Now, drummers are annoying, and, you know, I could be annoying, that's my good lady. Now, when I was finally having my testicles removed, my wonderful surgeon, one of them doctors, talk in plain English, you know. My doctor is always asking me to bring in a sample of my stools. Bring a sample of my bloody stools, you know. I took him a lovely Moroccan hand-carved one, all the way in my head. I said, there's a sample of my stools, you know. I looked at it now, like shit on his shoes, you know. And if you are talking about doctors, don't get me started. I'm thinking of using that as a catchphrase. Don't get me started on doctors. Doctors, have you heard about this door-handled diagnostics nowadays? You know, I think you go into a doctor to see for something, and then just as you've got your hand on the fucking thing, I went in to see my doctor or to get some blood tests or something, you know. And just as I got my hand on the door handle, he said, "Oh, by the way, Jim, you're clinically obese." I thought, "Well, you're a fucking four-eyed spotty ginger herbert, but I've got the fucking good grace not to say anything, you know what I'm saying?" Anyway, this surgeon, he was just about to remove both my testicles. Okay, he said, "Jim, while you're under the anaesthetic, would you like some prosthetics?" "Would you like some prosthetics?" Nearly. And I went, "Sorry, I'm not with you." He said, "Would you like some falsies put in?" And I went, "Falsies, you fucking man, I've got tits bigger than fucking Jordan, and that's your fault. All the female hormone therapy, you know what I'm saying? Dear, you know." He said, no, why are you under the anesthetic? "I can put some false testicles in, you know." So he showed me some pictures, and in the end, I thought, well, it's only to do once. You know what I'm saying? It's only to do once. So what I chose was the Sony digital bumpers front and rear, overhead cam, racing stripe, golden cojones 2000. And they're a right pair of belters, I'm telling you. And if I do get annoying, and I probably have been, and please forgive me, I'm going to show you now, I'm going to demonstrate what happens if you kick me in the bollocks. Okay? Don't try this at home. So if I get really annoying, this is what happened if you kick me in the road. You know, the Golden Cohort 2000. Sometimes I can get a Radio Forum, Sky Sports, and if I ever figure out what Bluetooth is, I'm going to get my phone hooked up to them, so my balls will go off and then I can answer my phone. And if you see me again doing this kind of stand-up, because I'm kind of learning it, next time I'm going to do ventriloquism. So instead of talking a lot of bollocks, I'll be talking through. So thank you ever so much for being so kind to somebody who's kind of new at this game. And, you know, have a very good night. Thank you so much.